All right, I'm here with Brad Silimperi, coming off this three-peat here at District 1 2019 Dual Meet Championships. And Brad, this Council Rock South Golden Hawk team has been incredible all season long. And, you know, I know the conversation where it's going to lead right away is, you know, now you're heading to Hershey and there's some work to be done up there. Tell me about the team's goals.
Absolutely. At the beginning of the season, it's kind of a no-brainer. We had a lot of guys back and a really good nucleus. And we knew we had a shot to, you know, make a run at District Duals. And the way they competed all year, I couldn't be more proud. And we got some heavyweights that are the unsung heroes because we didn't have any bodies coming into the season. And although they may not win, you know, a ton of matches for us, they're learning. And we don't do this without them. So this is for them, and it's just really cool. And our seniors, to be able to do it the 3 years, you know, District 1, we're just really proud of that. So now, yeah, we're off to state. States and the goal is to get on that podium.
Good. You know, that's Let's talk a little bit about this Springboard match. Now, earlier I said that, you know, I didn't expect the outcome to be different, but I did expect the lineup to be different for Springboard, and it was, and it was different for you as well. And, you know, Chase Smith was not in the lineup. I'm not sure if you knew that going in, if he was going to be in there or not, but I was wondering about that. But tell me a little bit about, you know, the middleweights there, because you guys can't, I mean, Corbett came out fired up. I mean, you guys were punishing the Springboard wrestlers on top.
Yeah,
I mean,
it was,
were you working on top a lot this
Yeah,
this
you know, we've been.
Weeks?
And although we knew the score was going to be closer, when we wrestled them the first time at our place, we got on a roll and there was no stopping it. And that happens in the sport, you know, the snowball can roll either way. And so we knew it was going to be a lot closer here. But, you know, I look at my cheat sheet. We look at worst case scenario, and I don't have any negatives on my list. And so that's pretty impressive. And
yeah,
we
that
did
that
the second time in a row. As we were either as expected or getting more bonus points. So just really pleased with that. Yeah, the middle of our lineup, we started off in a good spot.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, we shut them down. I think, you know, they were warned for stalling a lot. Our guys were looking to score points. And even though some of the matches were close, I think we were dominating. You know, good solid ground and pound on top. And
yeah, Peter Eklund, you know, you talk about your upperweights. Peter Eklund, you know, over the years, you have put him in some really tight spots.
I mean,
and I'll tell you what, he always comes out and is moving forward and wrestling well. And again, it's guys like that in your program that that confidence thing just grows and
you
builds.
Know, your best guys are supposed to win. Your best guys are supposed to put up bonus points. But to win a district duel, to get on a state podium duel, it's all those other cast members that are crucial. You know, guys just weighing in, making weight, and not getting a chance to wrestle. And it stinks for those guys. But that changes strategies. You know, Pete Eklund, I don't know if he's ever missed a practice. And that goes for spring and summer and club stuff. And you just to see him progress has just been awesome. And he won a league title last week. So his name's on the board forever.
There you go.
You know, and again, he tries his best and the team really rallies around him. So it's pretty cool. Yeah, Corby, he's kind of our senior spokesman.
Okay.
He's a great leader and, you know, he was definitely fired up and yeah, he leads by example. So
yeah, can you tell me a little bit about the lightweight trio dropping down now? I mean, you know, that gives you a little more flexibility in your dual meet lineup. I mean, from, you know, being a former coach, I look at that and I'm like, you still got Cavan in there. You can insert him when you need to. You know, Rikini can go up again.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, what does that do for, you know, your lineup with some of these better teams?
It's kind of bittersweet. I mean,
yeah,
yes, for strategy-wise, it's great because it does give us, you know, some options. We got, you know, Mo Savvy in there. Who will wrestle with anybody. He's a freshman at 26. You got Landon Moore, senior. We can plug in at 38-45. You got Joel Martinovsky, who'd be starting varsity almost any other program.
Agreed.
But I do want to talk about Cavan Kinney. He's ranked in the top five in the district, and now our guy's dropped, and you know we'll see what happens. But he's just been absolutely incredible. He's really wrestled beyond our expectations, and it's getting better every day because he gets to go with those hammers.
Sure.
And, like, yeah, I know he was pretty disappointed. And unfortunate part because I want everybody to wrestle.
But can you step back and take a look at that team approach? Because, I mean, I know that you guys, you know, I know you're about the individual postseason like we all are. But from a team perspective, I mean, he's got to understand. I mean, Mendez has been in this position.
Yeah absolutely. And you know, we stress to these guys, that's the best teams have this problem. The teams that are not competing to go to state duels, you know, they don't have that problem. And so it is a good problem to have. And I'm just proud of our guys. They understand it is a team event right here. So it's very, very different. And then we'll see what happens in the individual postseason. But, Yeah, Kevin's been a huge part of what we're doing.
Good, good. All right, well, listen, I don't want to hold you any longer. You've been hitting in this gym for 2 days, and we wish you the best of luck up there. I think you have Hazleton out of the gate, if I'm correct.
I haven't bracket watched. That's for you guys in the forum, guys, to look at.
Well, I'll share it with you right there. There it is.
It's Hazleton area.
All right. So get to work right now.
We will.
All right.
We will.
All right, congratulations, man.
All right,
man.
Thanks. And we hope to make District 1 proud. So.
All right, see you.
All right, thanks.
Okay.